जम्मू लिंक्स न्यूज टॉप स्टोरीज इज ब्रॉट टू यू बाय तस्या हर्बल्स अल्कोहल बेस्ड हैंड सैनिटाइजर विद नीम एंड एलोवेरा एक्सट्रैक्ट्स हेल्पिंग इंडिया फाइट कोविड-19। लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर मनोज सिन्हा ऑन ट्यूजडे विजिटेड गांधरबल इन सेंट्रल कश्मीर ऑन ट्यूजडे एंड रिव्यूड डेवलपमेंटल सिनेरियो इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट बिसाइड्स टेकिंग स्टॉक ऑफ कोविड-19 मैनेजमेंट। द LGE इनॉग्रेटेड सम डेवलपमेंटल प्रोजेक्ट्स एज वेल। During the meeting, the officials briefed the LG about various developmental works being undertaken and measures taken by the administration to effectively deal with the COVID-19 pandemic. The army has begun its probe and recorded statements in connection with last month's encounter in Shopian area of South Kashmir after families in Rajouri area of Jammu region filed a complaint with the Jammu and Kashmir police about its members missing from the same region. Srinagar-based defence spokesperson Colonel Rajesh Kalia issued a statement saying a high-level court of inquiry into Operation Amshipura in Shopian is under progress. Colonel Kalia said the army is committed to ethical conduct of all counter-terrorist operations. Traffic on the 270-kilometer-long Srinagar-Jammu National Highway, the only all-weather road connecting Kashmir Valley with the rest of the country, was resumed this afternoon after remaining closed since early Tuesday morning due to landslides triggered by rain during the night. However, the National Highway, the only road linking the Union Territory of Ladakh with Kashmir Valley, and 86-kilometer-long historic Mughal Road are open for one-way traffic. Traffic on the Srinagar-Jammu National Highway was suspended, followed landslides triggered by rains during the night at Nihad in Ramban. Former Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister Omar Abdullah on Tuesday said he was not surprised after Madhya Pradesh announced all jobs in government offices exclusively for the people from the state when jobs in J&K and Ladakh are for everyone. The Vice President of the National Conference was reacting to MP Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan's announcement that jobs in the state will be exclusively for the youth from MP only. A newly recruited terrorist of Al-Badr outfit was arrested by security forces during a Naka checking in South Kashmir district of Shopian. Sources said, on a tip-off about the movement of terrorists, the Naka was established at Dragan Sugan in Shopian by Rashtra Rifles Special Operation Group of Jammu and Kashmir Police and CRPF. During checking, terrorist of Al-Badr identified as Hilal Ahmed Sheikh was nabbed. A spell of overnight rainfall broke the prolonged dry spell in Kashmir Valley even as the summer capital Srinagar had on Monday recorded the hottest August day in the last nearly four decades. Many places in the Kashmir Valley received a spell of rainfall during the night. The valley witnessed rains and thunderstorm with lightning and gusty winds which continued at few places till the morning. Pakistani Rangers opened fire on border outposts along the international border in Jammu and Kashmir's Kathua district. BSF troops guarding the border retaliated, resulting in exchanges. They said Pakistani Rangers fired from machine guns at forward border outposts of Hiranagar sector on Monday night. There were no casualties in the firing. Power employees held protest across UTs of J&K and Ladakh against the government decision of privatization, demanding immediate revocation of the same. Power employees under the banner of PECC comprising of various unions of PDD held protest across all districts in Jammu Kashmir on the issue of government proposed Electricity Amendment Bill 2020 for privatization of the power sector through transferring the assets created with public's exchequer inclusive of natural resources to private houses. The wreath-laying ceremony of two Central Reserve Police Force personnel who lost their lives in a terrorist attack in Baramulla on August 17 was held in Budgam on Tuesday. The Jawan's driver Khurshid and Constable Lovekush hailed from Bihar, according to R.R. Bhatnagar, advisor to Lieutenant Governor of Jammu and Kashmir, who was also present to pay tributes to the Jawans who had made the supreme sacrifice. Special Director General CRPF Kashmir Zulfikar Hassan meanwhile said that the security forces will keep thwarting terrorist attempts in the region. Newly appointed Comptroller and Auditor General of India Girish Chandra Murmu called on Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday, a day after meeting President Ramnath Kovind. He was appointed as the first Lieutenant Governor of Jammu and Kashmir after it was made a Union Territory last year. Earlier this month, he became the first tribal person to take charge as the CAG of India. Expressing grave concern over the growing incidence of militancy in J&K, Harshdeep Singh, chairman JKNPP and former minister, today accused the central government for its failure to curb PAK-sponsored terror in the erstwhile state, despite having taken control of law and order in the new UT. He said martyrdom of four security men yesterday in North Kashmir should serve an eye-opener for the narcissistically self-flagellated regime, including in incessant chest-thumping with vague, nauseating claims of having controlled militancy in J&K post-Article 370 abrogation. India has set another record of conducting nearly 9 lakh COVID-19 tests in a single day, which is the highest so far. 8,99,864 tests have been conducted in a single day. With this, the cumulative tests have reached 3,09,41,264. Even with such a high level of testing, the positivity has remained low, that is 8.81%, compared to the weekly national average, that is 8.84%. India has also recorded the highest single-day recoveries of 57,584 in the last 24 hours.